on, I would say, VMware focuses on the company's data initiatives. I currently work on Serengeti, which is an open source project to enable the deployment of clusters in virtualized environment. And it interfaces with various users interested in virtualizing their workloads. Like VMware, current Android roles and other big data analytics providers, which is quite large in size. Welcome, Kevin.
Simplify and optimize their operations. To that end, we have announced Project Serengeti. It was released June 2012 at the Hadoop Summit. It's an open source project that simplifies Hadoop development. So basically, you can deploy a Hadoop cluster on a virtual platform in 10 minutes. You can customize the Hadoop cluster very simply. You have the flexibility, freedom of choice to use whatever Hadoop distribution you choose. And we aim to make it a one-stop command center for running your Hadoop on the virtual. So how do you go about running Serengeti? Serengeti is available as a virtual appliance. It runs on vSphere, which is the VMware virtualization platform. So you've installed Serengeti virtual appliance. What you do is, I've got some simple pseudo screenshots of how you might go about with the Serengeti command by SSH to your Serengeti server. That's what you get after you've installed the Serengeti virtual appliance. And then creating a cluster is as simple as saying cluster create, give it a name, after which you can list your cluster and say, okay, I have two clusters currently. I have one master node in my third cluster, three worker nodes. It'll tell you the number of CPUs, memory, etc., allocated to each type of node in your cluster. Serengeti can also deploy things like time and date as well, and I'll talk about that later. We're continuing to work elsewhere on the Hadoop stack. But, deploying clusters is a simple task that you can do that in about 10 minutes if you're talking about your five nodes. Once you deploy a cluster, what do you do? You can run MapReduce, hey, iJobs, just from the command line there. You can resize the cluster, right? You can say, okay, I have five nodes to begin with, I need more. Let me resize it, I need 10 of the nodes now. And Serengeti will go off and do that for you. This is an example of how you can customize a cluster. So we provide a JSON spec file with that, so that you have that flexibility. You go in and edit that spec file and you can say, what distro you want, how many node groups you want, and what services are associated with each node. So in this instance, you have a master node group where the name node and job type sits. You can decide what kind of storage and how much storage to allocate to it, shared or local. You can size your CPU, memory, etc. And towards the bottom there, there is a key, HA flag there, that can be used to turn on and off the high availability protection, which I'll talk about later on. So I've given you kind of a run through how you would work with Serengeti. Now, where we are right now with the project and the Serengeti, right? Again, we're looking at various distros to make them available for Serengeti, so the flexibility to choose from those distros. Work in progress is to support multiple projects. So today, Serengeti can deploy big and high server. We're working on HBase for future release. Again, it's open source. We welcome contributors. We've already spoken to various companies, other enterprises who are interested in contributing various parts to Serengeti. Now, one other thing that we're doing, and this is kind of orthogonal to Serengeti, is that we're contributing what we call Hadoop virtualization extensions to Apache Hadoop. The purpose of this is to make Hadoop virtualization aware. What do I mean by this? Logically, if you virtualize Hadoop, you actually have another layer, another virtualization layer, right? So it'll be interesting for me to know what the topology is in my Hadoop cluster. Whether two Hadoop nodes on different VMs are actually sitting on the same physical node. How does this help me? This helps me when I want to replicate data, right? I don't want to put the same piece of data on two VMs that actually sit on the same physical host. This helps me with reading, when I want to read from the data that's closest to me. This helps me when I'm scheduling jobs to be close to the data that I want to be close to. Another aspect is flexibility, right? A lot of people associate virtualization with shared storage. That is true, there are a lot of benefits that you can get from shared storage on a virtual platform. But sometimes it's cost prohibitive, oftentimes it's cost prohibitive to load data on shared storage. So like I said, as you saw, the JSON spec file loaded, you can specify local or shared storage for the new cluster. You have a choice. So figure out what needs your needs, right? If you have a small data set and it's more important to get started quickly, you might choose shared storage. If you have a lot of data, you might want to choose local storage. So, you know, the benefits to both the shared storage can be easy to provision, automated rebalancing, and then there are high availability tools, which I'll talk about in my next segment that you can leverage when you use shared storage. However, with global storage, obviously, we talked about it earlier, you may want to do it for cost or for bandwidth purposes. Just a side note, some folks who have spoken to have questions about performance and virtual. So we've done performance studies. I think the takeaway from this chart is that performance on virtual can be comparable to performance on physical. So what you see here is physical would be the light blue column, the leftmost light blue column, so that's the elapsed time for different benchmarks. And then on the same physical machines, you can deploy one VM, or two VMs per physical machine, or four VMs per physical host. So that's something you can do with the VMs. And yes, there's some overhead when you deploy, you know, one VM on a physical machine, or on a physical machine, but actually when you start getting to like two VMs per physical host, the performance degradation is minimal and sometimes even faster than native physical. So if you want more information on the performance benchmarks, we do have a white paper that's available on the VMware website. Alright, so we talked about simplicity, making it easy to run, to deploy and run Hadoop on virtual, easy to configure, reconfigure. Let's talk about high availability, because that's something else that was interesting to many of the enterprise customers in helping. So single points of failure, what I want to stress is that VMware offers, you know, high availability protection to multiple, the same protection you turn it on the same way, you administer it the same way to multiple critical services within your Hadoop stack. If you name your job tracker, it would be the meta stores in Hive, HTML, or the management server. And there are various types of API protection that you can benefit from. But before that, we talked about shared and local storage prior to this. You know, one thing you can do is to go to a hybrid storage model to leverage the benefits of both, right? You want the cheap local storage, you want the high bandwidth of local storage, but you also want the HA protection that shared storage can give you. So what we would recommend in that situation is that you put your critical services, name your job tracker on the shared storage, or the rest of your data on local storage, and that way you can get the best of both worlds. So there are different types of HA protection. One is vMotion, which is mainly for planned downtime. You can actually move a virtual machine that is running. You know, as a user, you actually won't see any break in the machine being running. And you can move one VM from a physical host to another. That's vMotion. Next one, that's VCNHA protection. So that's for unplanned outages, right? And this protects against failure at different levels. If the host goes down, if the VM goes down, at the application level too, they can look inside the application and see if the application is running. If there's something wrong with it, it will restart that VM, the VM that say has the name on another physical host that's still running. It usually takes about several minutes to restart on a different physical host. We've also contributed code that helps Hadoop jobs pause and resume once, say, the main node comes back up. And actually, in the several minutes that it takes to restart, most of that time is actually used in detecting the failure of the service. And then lastly, there's vSphere fault tolerance for the highest level HA protection. What happens here is you run two VMs in lockstep, such that when one goes down, there's actually no downtime, and switch over automatically to the other one. So, folks, these are the different types of HA protection that you can get when running Hadoop cluster and critical services on a virtual platform. It is something that's tried and tested by lots of VMware customers. It's not the attach rate for things like high availability is about 90%. So it's a very mature technology and it's a single mechanism to achieve HA for the entire Hadoop stack. And it's very easy to set up with Serengeti. It's just a single flag or single click to do that. So that's been resonating a lot with enterprise customers. Alright, so third area I want to dive into today before I let you go. So elasticity and multi-tenancy. This is something interesting for people who especially want to offer Hadoop as a service, whether it's internally, to the internal users or even in the public cloud. So this slide is titled Evolution of Hadoop on VMs. So if you look at the left, that's kind of usually what you're used to, right? You have the single Hadoop node, storage and compute combined. That's basically how a physical node might look. And that's how we started out with Serengeti. We deploy worker nodes like this. But if you're talking about elasticity, the problem with this model is that it gets hard to scale, let's say, your compute and data center. Or if you want to shut off virtual machines, it gets hard to do because once you shut off your virtual machine, you lose access to the data on that virtual machine. So what we've done is Serengeti can actually deploy the data and the compute layer separately. The benefit from that is you get elasticity in your compute layer. Typically, you want the data to be persistent. And then, depending on the time of day or when you run your new job, you can spin up your compute cluster independently of the data. And then when you're done, you can spin it back down. Your compute is stateless, so you can go ahead and do that. And this helps us to raise utilization. Taking it a step further, that's kind of the multi-tenancy case. You can give different VMs different tenants. Tenant 1 gets its own VM, tenant 2 gets its own VM. This way you get performance and security isolation, VM level, VM grade isolation. You can say tenant 1 gets this amount of resources, tenant 2 gets that amount of resources, and you can guarantee those resources much more effectively. So some ideas for how you can use elasticity and multi-tenancy, right? So you can have production Hadoop jobs sharing your cluster with ad hoc work, for instance. Kind of an in-house DMR. In fact, we have spoken to people who are interested in that sort of thing, offering in-house DMR when going public is not really an option because it's hard to transfer data, for instance, or the data can't go out to Amazon DMR. Perhaps then you want to integrate your Hadoop jobs with other big data workloads. So that's another reason why you might want multi-tenancy and elasticity. And then finally, even Hadoop and big data workloads. So you can have Hadoop ephemeral Hadoop clusters running alongside web servers if you're an e-commerce company, perhaps. You expect most of your web traffic during the day, you spin up your web servers during the day, right? And then during the nighttime, you scale back the web server component, and then you scale out your Hadoop component to do your offline log processing, for instance. So these are all kind of the elasticity and multi-tenancy piece is kind of more forward-looking at this point, and we continue to work on these projects with our customers in mind. So again, why virtualize Hadoop? In summary, three things: simplicity, high availability, elasticity, and multi-tenancy. And if you want more information on what we're doing with Hadoop, we have a VMware Hadoop website at the right. You can find the performance white papers that I've been mentioning there. We'll talk about the HA solution there. And if you want to try Serengeti, it's available for download at projectserengeti.org. So that's pretty much all I have to say today.
Thank you, Darren. I'm going to see your questions for him for this session. No questions. Thank you. Thanks for coming. Oh, that is a question.
So, you talked about Hadoop virtualization extension and product.